Welcome back to the IBSP. Here's your host, Foxy New.
Welcome back, fight fans. Welcome back. Canelo Alvarez can't be great fighting white fighters, only blacks. Look, let's break it down honestly and objectively as possible. And you know, I've gotten thousands of requests to do this video. People are blowing up my DMs. People are reaching out to me all over YouTube. People are constantly contacting me about this video. And you know, I just decided that I'm going to do it. Dante's Big Breast Nation has come out and stated that Canelo Alvarez is not the best fighter at 168 pounds. He's avoiding black fighters, essentially saying fighting white fighters and becoming undisputed is meaningless. He has to fight undefeated black fighters to prove that he is the best fighter. He also ranks David Benavidez as the number one fighter in the division over Canelo Alvarez. So look, let's break this down even further. You know, Dante's Big Fat Ass Nation pretty much is saying that, you know, Caleb Plant, Callum Smith, and Billy Joe Saunders are not top fighters simply because they're white. He's being racially biased. He doesn't recognize the fact that all three of these fighters were undefeated. He doesn't recognize the fact that all three of these fighters are in their prime when Canelo Alvarez fought them. And he does not recognize the fact that all three of these fighters were world champions. So, you know, Dante's Big Breast Nation is simply a hater and racially biased. I mean, the guy looks at these guys and he doesn't think much of them simply because of the color of their skin. And what he doesn't understand is, you know, does your skin color determine your skills? No. Does your skin color determine your abilities? No. Are there different world title belts for different color skin? No. Skin color is meaningless in the sport of boxing. Your skills, you know, your abilities, and the fact that you can win a world title has nothing to do with the color of your skin. This is what his big fat ass simply does not understand. And, you know, as far as the undefeated black fighters go, you know, he doesn't hold this same energy when it comes to Demetrius Andrade. Does Demetrius Andrade have a resume full of, you know, undefeated black fighters on his resume? No. Does Jermall Charlo? No. Does, you know, Tank Davis? No. Does Terrence Crawford? No. But he holds Canelo Alvarez to a different standard. And Canelo Alvarez, ironically, has fought more undefeated black fighters than all of these guys. Let's be honest and unbiased. You really can't fix stupid. And not only that, you know, as far as the racial aspect, you see, was Usyk going undisputed? Undisputed by beating Murat Gassiev. Is that any less impressive because he was white? Was it any less impressive Teofimo Lopez beating Vasyl Lomachenko simply because he was white? Did it make any sense that Josh Taylor, you know, is his undisputed reign less meaningful because he beat Jose Ramirez, who is not black? Does that make any sense? No. Dante's Big Breast Nation is simply racially biased and a hater. Not only that, you know, when you talk about Jermall Charlo, an undefeated black fighter who's also a world champion, Canelo Alvarez offered him the fight in 2019 and he rejected the fight. And at the end of the day, Dante's Big Fat Ass Nation doesn't even talk about this, doesn't even acknowledge this. We got to be honest and unbiased, and you got to keep that same energy. And not only that, when you get to David Benavidez, how in the hell is David Benavidez number one over Saul Canelo Alvarez when David Benavidez holds no belts at 168 pounds? He has no elite wins at 168 pounds, and he has no unifications at the weight. Make it make sense. Canelo Alvarez is the best fighter in the division as well as the planet. Race has nothing to do with greatness because men lie, women lie, but the facts don't lie.